Yo, 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 good morning world, it's King Kai. I'm about to show you how I edit my vocals in the FL Studio 20. Stay tuned. Hey guys, what's going on? It's King Kai. Here I already booted up a song. I'm going to show you how I edit my vocals in FL Studio 20. Here I booted up this song called Bad. My friend Jay Anime and I are on the song. And here I'm going to take off the effects I put on the vocals and start from scratch. As you can see, I have the hook, the verse, the ad-libs, etc, etc. Oh, and if you didn't know, if you have FL Studio and you're watching this, if you want to reset a channel, you know, and you go to a channel that you didn't do anything on, like these, right? And you select, or these, you select file, and then you have to click and drag this. It says save mixer track as. Click and drag it, and boom, it just resets it for you like that. So I'm gonna do that with the rest of these. So these are my vocals that I just reset. Now I'm gonna play you the track with the raw vocals. Yeah. Yeah.
The fire guy King Kai.
Every time I'm up, I get tested. I don't wanna be the one you mess with. Father got my back, I'm not stressing. Shorty come around and want my precious. She's not even bad. She's not even bad. Okay, so those are raw vocals now. Those are just vocals that I recorded into my microphone. So what you do for your vocals on FL20 or FL Studio in general, whatever version you have, these are all set to a channel. Like these numbers here mean it's on channel 13, like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I do it in order. 13, 13, 14, 15, 15. Those are all my vocals. So I'm just going to edit mine for now. Set it to 13 by clicking and dragging it. Or if you see this green on the side, you highlight it, you go to the channel, press Control L, and that'll pop up. I'll just rename it hook, like I did before. I want my vocals to sound a certain way. For the hook, I usually do more reverb because I want it to sound full, wide. So the first thing I usually do is go here, and I use a preset parametric EQ to use a preset, the 4018 cut, or a friend of mine likes to just use a 40 cut, but I use a 4018. Doesn't really make a difference. What I usually do is just bring it down to the bass. I like a little bit of bass in my voice, so I keep some bass in. Not sub bass though. You don't want sub bass in your vocals. So the next thing I'll do is put another equalizer on it, and I use another preset called Vocal Presence. When it's on Vocal Presence, what it's doing is again taking out the sub bass, and it ducks a little bit of the low mid and really boosts up the highs. The treble area, right? The highs are what makes your vocals crisp and clean. As for me, the way I talk and the way I speak, I don't really need this up there, so I just bring it flat down. That's just for me. If it's for you, you know, you might want to have that back up there, you know, and not reset it. You could bring it here. What I'm going to tell you in FL Studio, when you put these effects on your channel, the order matters. So that's why I'm doing this first, and that's why I'm doing this second. And reason why, because I want to cut out these frequencies first, and then secondly, I want to lower these frequencies with the vocal preset. So the next thing I'll do, since I know that the way I talk, I have very sharp S's, I use Spitfish. It's a free de-esser. You can go and get it online. It's a VST. You just download it. It's free. This, I have a personal preset that says Kai. So, you know, my S's are pretty heavy, so I'll put that on there. So I use this de-esser because it really helps out with the way I talk. The next thing you want to do, this thing called the sound goodizer. This is basically a distortion tool. It only has four settings, right? I like my voice in setting B. I'll play and you can hear the differences. Every time I'm up, I get tested. I don't want to be the one you mess with.
Yeah, so I like it in B. And this knob is just the intensity level. So I like to lower it down probably, you know, a quarter of the way. That's how I do it. It's just, you got to listen to it. You got to listen to your vocals and see how you like it lowered down. So the next thing, after the sound goodizer, the first thing I do is a multi-band compressor. Oh, that's the wrong thing. A multi-band compressor. And this thing here is so helpful because this really compresses your vocals in every frequency that you have. The low, the mid, and the highs. I found a way to turn compression 6 vocals, right? But I modified it. And I saved my own preset. And I have Chai 1 and I have a Chai 2 preset. So these two presets are my main go-to presets when I do my vocal. I modify them from the preset of comp 6. That's what it says. So I for this one, I'll probably use Chai 1. And you'll hear a difference immediately as I'm playing it.
Every time I'm up, I get tested. I don't want to be the one you mess with.
All right. So I'm going to take off everything so you hear the big difference.
Every time I'm up, I get tested. I don't want to be the one you mess with. Father got my back, I'm not stressing. Shorty come around and want my precious.
Right. So you hear the difference in how everything sounds. The next thing I'll usually do after I put the two EQs, the Spitfish, the Soundgoodizer, the multi-band compressor, I will use what's called reverb, but I like reverb too. And I'll use a preset for the Cathedral Hall preset. I'll modify it. I'll bring the decay down and the wet factor down, probably at about 30%. If you look up here, you see the percentage. So I'll bring it down to 30%. Usually that's what I do, around there, doesn't matter, 31, 32, 33, whatever, 29, doesn't matter. Just make sure it sounds good to you. So now when you hear this, you hear the reverb, which makes the vocal more present.
Every time I'm up, I get tested. I don't wanna be the one you mess with. Father got my back, I'm not stressing.
All right, so you hear how that sounds now. It sounds way better. For this particular thing, it's a little sing-songy. So I'll throw some auto-tune, but in here they call it pitcher. And I'll do it, I'll listen to it, I'll set it to the male gender, because my voice is deep. So that's what I have to use. And I'll go to whatever key. I'm not really good with the keys, so, or the scales. So I will have to listen through each one and see what scale I'm singing, or, you know, kind of, yeah, singing in, and really try and get the right one.
Every time I'm up, I get tested. I don't want to be the one you mess with. Father got my back, I'm not.
All right, so it sounds like I'm in C sharp minor. So this knob here is a speed. It's like the intensity again of how much autotune is on the voice. So I will listen
every
to it.
Every time I'm up, I get tested. I don't want to be the one you mess with. Father got my back, I'm not.
I like that. I like it at 60 right now. So that's looking pretty good. And then, you know, that seems about it. That's all I will really put. I might add some delay in there. I'll keep the reverb at the bottom because, like I said, the order matters. But I'll keep the reverb at the bottom because I want reverb over everything that's above it. So I'll put delay, and I'll use Fruity Delay too. You could adjust the time, which is how fast this thing is going. Like, I'll just play this again a little lower now.
Every time I'm up,
and I don't want that. So that's too fast for me. So I'll put it at 8. And then these knobs, these volume knobs, they adjust how you're listening to it. Like, you can make it like the echoes after the main vocal decay faster, or you can make this one will make it decay faster, and this one will make the echoes loud or not loud. So you hear them every time I'm up, I get tested, right? So that you'll hear that, and then everything after that will be set to whatever this volume is. it'll be set. So if you want them, like, every time I'm up, I get to, and you hear it again, every time I'm up, I get to, it's a little lower. That's the preset. That's, so it'll start at the volume you set it and get lower and lower and lower. So whatever volume, if you want it all the way up, so it's like every time I'm up, and then every time, and get lower. That this is a knob that helps you do that. So I hope it's not too confusing, but this is the knob where the volume of the echoes that happen after your main vocal is played, you set that lower than the main vocal. That's what you usually want to do. You don't want to bring it all the way up because it'll be louder. It'll be like your main vocal and then boom, it's louder. Don't do that. That's a horrible way to mix your track. You usually want it lower, but at a nice, decent volume. I don't like my echoes too noticeable, so I usually turn them down like this.
Every time I'm up, I get tested. I don't wanna be the one you mess with.
So now you really hear the echoes, but they're not too prominent or in the front of everything. They're perfectly in the back. So now let's play everything all together, and I'll just play it from there.
She not even bad. She wanna do me. She see what I have. She not even bad.
Oh, another thing, just the same way that I blank these out, is the same way I can, add them in. So this is 13, and if I like the settings that I set on this side for this channel and I want to copy it, I can copy it to 14 right here, and it'll put the same exact VSTs that you put on your channel on the one you're copying it to. Maybe you set it to how you like it and you want to adjust it a little bit and you want to tweak it, so you preset all of them, and like, oh, you could adjust the volumes higher or lower, or say you don't want this kind of reverb on there, you want a different reverb, so you'll use this one, right? I usually set them always to 30. You want this one because this is the verse, or you have ad libs, so if it's the ad libs, you'll put something like a radio effect on the EQ, right? And you'll lower that like that because you want it low and you want it in the back and not noticeable. And that's how you do it. So if you want to use the main thing as your preset and you just want to adjust it, go to, like I said, file, save mixer track, state as, click and drag it to wherever you want and it'll be like that. So that's all you have to do. And this is how I mix my vocals. Of course I'll go back and I'll adjust this and I'll name this verse and you know, whatever else, ad libs, hook ad libs, all that, etc. But this is how you do it. And thank you for watching. If you're watching this, thank you I hope you learned something about how to mix your track and how to make it better. Every mix is different and there's no wrong mix if it sounds good. So this is the way that I do it. And I have my best friend Kevin does it totally different for me. Like, he'll do it so different and it'll come out good. It'll come out good. But this is the way I do it. I like how it sounds. So you have to discover how you'd like your mix to be. Subscribe to my channel if you like what you've seen. And I have more like this. Let me know. Comment in the comment section if you like this, or tell me what you want to see from this channel. I'm doing a lot of music and tutorials and beats and things like that. So just let me know what you really like to see. So like I said again, thank you for watching. I hope you learned a lot. And stay tuned.